Wow, that's pretty crazy, dude. Wait, I don't even have anything on the screen yet. Hold on. Hold on. I probably need to set up my, yeah, the name of the stream and stuff. The save video quality, watch now. I think, things should be set up anytime soon. Alright, let me go to the creator dashboard. So cool, man. It's so fucking confusing. There's like a million things you could do. The chat rules are set to be excellent to each other and have fun. I don't want people to be fucking having fun. Oh, hold on. Okay. Today we're gonna watch the... how is it called? Ubisoft reveal thing. Ubisoft reveal thing witnessing ceremony. And that's gonna be about it. I'm gonna restream it, then play games. And, I don't know, let's say my own tags are Ubisoft, viewing, I don't know, restream or whatever. And if I'm not allowed to do it, then I'll get banned. So fuck it. Sicko mode. Alright. Let me put something on the screen. I just kind of need to go and find it, I guess. Should I restream it from YouTube or from Twitch? Or I can restream somebody else restreaming it. Damn, that's gonna be so hot. Okay. Ubisoft Forward 22, right? That's how it's called. Oh, there's like a million people. Let's watch the IGN version of it. Because those dudes are hot. I'm not gonna put their chat on screen because everybody's just gonna be shitting on stuff. So not... There's not a lot of point behind that. So yeah, man. Welcome to Twitch. This is how life works now. This is something different. There's probably nobody watching right now and I can't really tell. Oh, there's one guy watching. Big ups, one guy. You're like the best guy ever because you're like the first guy. You probably came here because you were a follower too. That is pretty dope though. I appreciate that. Let me just put in the edge so everybody can have something to watch. Ubisoft Forward. You guys, I'm a big fan of Assassin's Creed and I'm pretty excited to see what they got cooking. Even though what they got cooking is probably going to be a... What used to be a DLC for Valhalla, and instead they made it into its own thing. So yeah, we're gonna get to see, man. It could be kind of exciting. Who knows? Who knows? And after that, we're gonna play some games, dude. Hey, what's up, Danny Darko? Welcome, man. I hope you're doing well as well. I'm just starting to actually figure out how this platform works, even though I've been having Twitch for quite a while. But I'm at the point where I want to separate, you know, gaming stuff and stuff like this, where I'm doing other stuff than DSP, from the channel where people just expect DSP stuff. And of course, the VODs from here, they're gonna go on YouTube because, of course, there's people that just don't like Twitch. I understand that, so that's how it's gonna be. And yeah, outside of that, we're gonna be chilling and we're gonna be having a couple of drinks later because it's gonna get a little bit late, so I gotta stay up. Maybe play some games, carry on with where I was today on stream, where I just scrolled through all my games and I told everybody about what I feel about every single game that I own, but we didn't play any of them. So yeah, maybe this time we will, you know what I mean? So yeah, this is gonna be super exciting. Perhaps. Or maybe it's gonna be trash, man. Who knows? It's a gaming event. But in any case, it's something that at least I have something to add for, because I've played every single one of those games. Particularly the main ones. The mainline Assassin's Creed. It's not the... I didn't play Liberation, Freedom Cry, and those like DLC type Assassin's Creeds. Well, let's see what's gonna happen. I think this is gonna start in about half an hour. So who knows? But oh no, it looks like we're going right into a trailer. Let's see what this is, man.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Ubisoft Forward.
Oh no,
we're
it's gonna start in actually like 25 minutes.
Coming up with updates on a bunch of fan favorite yep. games before we kick off the main show.
Absolutely. And if you want to find out the latest about the world of Mario plus Rabbids, Sparks of Hope,
Mario Rabbids,
sail the high seas in Skull and Bones, stick with us as you're already in the right place.
Wait,
and
what?
That's not all. as today's show is available in 11 languages, 4 sign languages, and 2 audio descriptions. Head over to the link below to find out more.
Now, on with the pre-show. Let's dive into some news and updates on games you're already playing, starting with Brawlhalla.
Let's see, Brawlhalla
updates. Where an exciting new character is joining
the fans. Let's check it out, man. I mean, it's a good game. Let's see what they got. What they got cooking. All right. Fine, I guess. I mean, let's see what the chat is saying for this. Oh yeah, they're totally distracted. They're not super hyped for this, honestly. Oh hey, this is Alucard. They're adding Alucard to Brawlhalla. Big ups, I guess. Because I mean, right now, what's his name? The Multiverses is taking all this game's lunch money. Of course it is. So they need to kind of step up a little bit. Brawlhallavania. Hell yeah. Let's see what next they got. Oh, this Rocksmith.
The Ubisoft Game Makers podcast is back for a new
podcast.
Season and with a new name, Bruh. The 10th Art. This fall, we're inviting Ubisoft developers.
Well, okay, this is a pre-show. What do you expect?
Ubisoft to explore video games and their place in pop culture and society.
The beauty of video games and science bringing them together is that we're bringing research or bringing science to society.
The beauty is we live in a society.
The relationship between science and video games, or how fashion and games influence each other, or whether anything can be a game. Check out the 10th Art today wherever
apparently,
you get your podcast.
Apparently, since they're still making Assassin's Creed, everything
sure
can be a game.
So you don't miss
just put
any
a hidden blade on it. Oh, I love the chat as well. They're just yelling
hey,
for
you?
Roblox.
Yeah, you. Sitting in front of this screen. I see you all. You.
See
stuck
me?
On a quest
what?
Looking for that blasted door key. Or
oh,
you
you're a
back,
gamer too, dude.
Always looking for new ways to dominate online in multiplayer matches.
Wow.
Well, today's your lucky day. Because now you can visit Ubisoft Game Plan for guides, walkthroughs, collaborations
Ubisoft
with your favorite
game plan.
Creators, and exclusive tips generated
what the fuck?
By the developers themselves. All of this is created
Ubisoft
to help
game
you
plan.
Get the most out of your game, whether it's brand spanking new or a seasoned classic.
Your number one
find
place for literal
on YouTube,
guides.
In-game and online.
Oh, there's
the
in-game as well.
Of an assassin.
But bro, these are the easiest fucking games of all time. We don't need guides for Assassin's Creed. It's like the easiest game ever. None of Ubisoft games got any degree of like difficulty to them, especially the present day ones.
As a child, I was taught never to fear the dark.
Oh, who is this?
To face my enemies with gritted teeth and a steady grip on my blade. But now, my hands tremble. Something has awakened in the mire. Glowing eyes watch in the night. Shadows slither through the woods, and twisted cackles taunt us.
Mm-hmm.
Brave samurai
sounds
venture
good, man.
Into the swamps.
Tell me more.
But what comes back? It isn't them.
Oh, it's a. Oh my god.
A deadly web has been woven, and there is no escape.
It's a zombie mode for Honor. Fantastic.
My teachings were wrong.
Fantastic.
Only fools.
Bruh.
Don't fear the dark.
It's like, how are they devolving? How does this even work? Whoa. So cool, bro. Look at him. He's a zombie. That was a pretty cool execution. I was kind of confused. Because he tried to grab the sword and he failed. Yeah, look, I'm not a professional reactor, so naturally, I'm gonna react on the spot because that's how amateurs do it. Real professionals write everything down, but I'm not a real professional. I'm a fake professional.
If you're just joining us, you're watching the Ubisoft Forward pre-show.
I know
just
what I'm watching. There was a literal thing on the screen the whole time telling what's happening. Hey, what's up, Grim Lobster, dude? What's up, dude? And Swickful, welcome, guys. Welcome. Thank you for your follows. I'm a little bit new around here, but I know that follows are useful, so I appreciate them. Thanks a lot. Let's see what Alexa Brumé has to say.
There's been awards, but above all, there's been some strong ties and learnings from both sides. And today, we're super thrilled to showcase some game from studios we've had the privilege of working with.
Okay.
Enjoy.
Oh, it's an indie showcase. All right, let's give him a shot.
I'm one of the founders of Skyward Entertainment. We are a brand new game company based here in Helsinki, Finland. We are currently working on a game called Second Stone. It will be a nostalgic mashup combining your back-to-the-roots classic action RPG with super tight platforming gameplay. In Second Stone, players will be drawn into this vast and beautiful world filled with adventure and excitement.
Sure
thing,
man.
However, everything is not as it seems. There is a dark, twisted, parallel universe that hides right in front of your eyes, and only you can get there. You will experience a thrilling and mind-bending story that unravels these secrets of this hidden realm,
one piece at a time.
To make your journey as fun as possible in Second Stone, we are working really hard in perfecting gameplay with satisfying tactical combat combined with state-of-the-art character progression systems. Early in development, we were lucky enough to meet with the amazing people at Ubisoft's Open Innovation Team.
Plus, they're a new studio, it's an indie type thing, so yeah.
A very detailed and professional review of our game pitch and demo. This helped us tremendously in taking Second Stone towards the right direction already like early on. Thank you all for watching, and please feel free to join us at skywardentertainment.com for more Second Stone.
Big ups, mate. Big ups, Second Stone. It's probably gonna be a pretty good game, man. Looks pretty good.
Hello, my name is Kim, and I'm the CEO of Unreliable Narrators, a Montreal-based studio dedicated to creating games that empower the voices of those that too often go unheard. We're currently hard at work on our very first project, a narrative-driven game set in 17th century Canada called Two Falls.
Two sets of tracks, fresh ones.
We're incredibly lucky to be in Montreal, where Ubisoft has been well established for now 25 years and a very active force in the gaming ecosystem. And we're really happy to have won the National Bank Favorites Award at the Ubisoft Montreal Indie Series. We also got marketing, business, and technical advice from the Ubisoft Entrepreneur Division.
What have you done to our home?
Two Falls is a game of contrasting perspective. Players will experience the intertwining journeys of Jeanne, a shipwrecked girl stranded far from the French colonies, and Maikan, a young Innu whose people have become afflicted by a strange illness. As the name of our studio suggests, nothing is quite as obvious as it seems in our work. Through branching and impactful dialogue options, light investigation mechanics, and wonder at the world around them, players will piece together the mysteries surrounding our two characters. Two Falls is currently set to release on PC in the fall of 2023. If you want to know more about Two Falls, please wishlist the game on Steam or give us a follow on Twitter. Thank you so much.
All right, Two Falls, man. Looks
pretty
good.
Oh, and by the way, that's not all.
I was tweeting this whole time, by the way,
now,
that I'm live on Twitch.
You can play indie games
really
on Ubisoft Plus, our subscription service, and it just so happens to be free to try this month.
Oh, of course it is.
So go ahead and check it out.
Of course it is. Your subscription service. Everybody got a subscription service now. What do they have on it? What do they have on it? Let's see. Blake. Okay. It's, I haven't heard of it, but it's like an indie, so yeah. Fell Seal, Arbiter's Mark. Okay. Evan's Remains. This looks very indie. Astrologaster. That looks indie as hell, man. The Last Friend. That looks pretty dope, though. And a normal lost phone. God damn. It's like when you lose your phone, it's like a lose your phone simulator. Ubisoft Plus, try it for free. Well, I guess you can go ahead, check it out, try it free. Oh, and they're giving you a Crew 2 update. Very excitement. A million excitements all at the same time. I've tried it out, not impressed, don't like it. Hey, it's Demeter. What's up, dude? Welcome. Which is the future of this style content? Not of the DSV stuff, but this stuff? This is right here, man. Feels good. Fits like a glove. Now watch this trailer for the Crew 2 with this guy driving a car. I'm feeling pretty good, man. Later on, listening some music, playing some games. Maybe like Dark Souls, maybe taking a couple of sips. You never know where night's gonna take me. Doing some song requests and stuff. I'm gonna check out how Twitch works, what kind of music I can play. Because honestly, on YouTube, it really bothers me that I can't play music and just kind of chill with like song requests and stuff. Because they always get like the stream blocked and it's really annoying. Hey, big ups to you as well, Greg. Welcome, man. Go get a drink. We're starting in like 13 minutes. And if you don't feel like getting a drink, you can get like a coffee or a tea or something. I'm probably gonna get one when there's like 5 minutes left on this countdown. I don't even know what this is. I guess they're premiering maybe having like tracks, like drift tracks, stuff like that. Because as far as I know, The Crew 2 is like an urban driving game. So yeah, that's kind of what I assume.
Hello everyone. Motorflix welcomes you back to the Dominion.
All right.
After your incredible experience alongside the Forsberg team, prepare to enjoy a whole new episode.
It's a DeLorean. That's right. It's a DeLorean. Remember the DeLorean?
Performance driving on all
from the hit movie Back to the Future from 1984? 80-something? I don't know, man. Maybe they will premiere a new Far Cry, but I don't think so. I really don't. Because, like, what, Far Cry 6 came out pretty recently. Maybe a... what's it called? Maybe a DLC. With, like, some new... I don't know, some new villain. That's not a celebrity. They'll never do that. It's always going to be a celebrity. So this is Dominion Frozen, I guess.
1986, Brittany, right. France. The Guillemot brothers launched Ubisoft. No internet, only creative minds ready to shape the future of entertainment. Today, Ubisoft still needs talented people to create the
Trans Am would have been cool. The Knight Rider one, like you say, that's a dope car.
Meet Pierre.
But that might already be in the game.
Pierre is the kind of person who lives his passion to the fullest. When the first Assassin's Creed game came out in 2007, he knew it could develop into a passion and become a major part of his life. And at first, he wondered if he should take the leap of faith.
Indeed, when I get passionate, I throw myself 100% into things.
Oh yeah,
so
it already is in the game.
I'd rather think twice.
In the end, he did.
Look at this, you
and
can actually
AC,
make your car
Pierre,
look like it. It's
Ubisoft
pretty fucking
would go
dope.
On quite an adventure together.
Or at least kind of similar.
Here is the story. Pierre didn't hop on the AC bandwagon immediately. It was a trailer that got him hooked.
No, not this one. Not this one either. Still wrong. It was a fan-made trailer in 2010.
Oh yeah, this is a classic fucking... Oh no. Oh, it's Tobuscus, dude! It's Tobuscus!
From a distance.
I watched it, and then I immediately showed up at my neighbor's, and I play AC all night.
He instantly became a fan of AC.
A lot of people found
he
the game
He loved the
from
story.
Those.
He loved the aesthetic, the
people.
Universe. He'd never traveled that much with any other game.
Hey, big ups, G Starwind for the
cosplay.
Follow, dude. Big ups.
He crafts and wears beautiful costumes based on the fictional worlds he loves.
All right.
So he saw huge potential.
The universe of AC was a playground in which I started
Come on,
to feel very creative.
He doesn't sound
creative.
Like me. What kind of accent is
really
this? This is like
and
a Montreal accent.
Sharing it with others is the biggest
this
reward.
This isn't my accent.
Pierre was one of the first ever in
you
France
right,
to cosplay Assassin's Creed.
You're the prince of lies.
His creations and his presence at events around the world
Demeter
quickly earned Pierre
man.
A growing Yikes. Audience within the community. He never missed an opportunity to meet up with people who shared his passion.
Yeah, that
he did miss the chance to
good.
Get an AC hoodie
it is a good
at Gamescom
cosplay.
1 year. He never forgot about that.
He
we'll
does
come
look
back
like
to
an
that
assassin,
hoodie
honestly.
Later. Pierre's dedication
we
put him on
again?
The radar at Ubisoft, so they
I'm
sent cosplay
confused.
Kits with top-secret unreleased character details, giving Pierre the time to make new costumes before game reveals.
Oh,
that's
so
quite
he's
a lot
shill.
Of trust.
And a lot of NDAs. That's it.
No,
we
Pierre is cool, man.
Never
he's not a chill. He looks like a chill guy.
Affirmative. It's quite a lot of trust.
At this stage, his passion had evolved into a lifestyle.
Now.
Pierre was stuck on AC, and AC was literally stuck on him. He wrote and shot a whole web series. He organized fan events where he orchestrated quizzes and contests.
Bro is
he
a fan.
Never missed
That's
an
nice.
Opportunity. Do you remember, Eve?
Oh, yes, I remember.
Ubisoft wants a community ambassador at E3 in Los Angeles. Clear the way, people. Here comes Pierre.
It was a dream come true.
I met more and more people, many from Ubisoft, and I finally felt like my commitment was recognized.
At this point, they all left because they all got harassed. Challenge as a player and a community leader.
It's impossible.
What achievement could he try to earn next? Pierre had a new dream, to be part of the teams at Ubisoft bringing AC to life. Over 7 years and 5 applications, he tried to join Ubisoft. He waited and hoped, never losing sight of his goal. That's a very long time, Pierre. What kept you motivated?
Well, I had a bit of perspective and explored new things, but I stayed positive and passionate.
Also known as trying again. Just make a new, submit a new application. That's what he did.
Put energy out in the world and hope it comes back.
Oh, yeah.
Right, Jean?
Wow, that's pretty deep. I knew Pierre as a community leader for years. So when a position opened in my team to run a community leader's activity, Pierre was the perfect fit.
Was that a follow? Yeah, it was a follow. Big up.
And that's how Pierre's dream came true. He finally joined Ubisoft. Today, Pierre is a project manager in the advocacy team.
What? I build bridges and relationships between the Ubisoft brands and advocacy teams.
Is he a lawyer?
Since joining Ubisoft, Pierre has of course found a new way of building community around another one of his passions.
I thought he would be like a costume designer. Dude is literally a cosplayer. Laser savers. What is he, a manager for like advocacy team?
This slight but significant detail.
You remember this one? As his first manager, when we changed job and we were no longer
working
together,
people that monitor the subreddit
that
mute all the dissent. That's those dudes.
Ubisoft.
Big ups.
And our communities.
What else can we say?
Well, I do appreciate the company, so you should come and join us.
Before I go, did you like this story? Head over to jobs.ubisoft.com.
Bro, this is like the weirdest, most corporate story I've ever seen in my life.
Towards creating the unknown with Ubisoft.
This is bizarre, man. This was weird. I don't know why they showed
this. And by the way, happy birthday, Assassins.
Oh, yeah, Assassin's Creed, big ups. Happy birthday, Assassins.
In just a little bit, we'll have trailers and announcements about your most.
Yeah, I thought he would be like in charge of like costume design or something like that. They put him on a weirdo like Reddit mod team.
Check it out.
Where you get to like,
hey everyone.
I don't know.
We are from the Anno team based in Ubisoft Mainz.
Silence Descent.
We love Anno City Builder series. Our latest
title, Anno
1800, transports you to the age of industrialization.
That
it challenges
is
you to build
sweet.
Grand cities.
Hey, what's up, Azonic?
Complex economic systems
how you
and logistics.
Pronounce
network,
it, I guess so, man.
And deal with competitors through diplomacy or military means. Use your fleet to settle on multiple islands, create trade routes, and expand your empire in different regions.
All right, this
in
looks nice.
In our current season 4, we're expanding the New World region of Anno 1800 with new content and stories, as well as standalone scenarios for special challenges. Our New World Rising DLC will complete that expansion with an additional population tier, new production chains, a grand monument, and new islands to explore.
All right, man.
We're That's very excited slick. To share with you a first glimpse at our upcoming content today. So,
but
check out this first teaser
is this
and make
a
sure
a PC only game. Never seen this on a PlayStation. Cuz it's like a city builder thing, but that doesn't really mean it. And I got to be limited. I'm confused. I'm confused, because it's like a pretty big title, kind of, but I haven't really heard anything. Might just be me. But let's see this trailer. Oh yeah, they are hard to play on the consoles. They are... It's not intuitive, really, to control it with a controller. You need that freedom that the mouse gives you to click all over the place.
We've all been there. In the midst of battle. At the heart of the race. On top of the highest mountain. Or just exploring. But some of us feel the need to stop and capture the moment. To get that perfect shot.
Sorry guys, got a phone call. Hey, big ups Ann Leaf, man. Big ups, thanks for the shout out. I appreciate it greatly. Hope we're not gonna let him down. We gotta deliver some hot waifus with big milkers. You know how it is, man. Of course, make sure if you haven't checked him out, go check out his stuff. I think he still does the DSP stuff on Twitch. Maybe not, but I don't know, man. I'm just diving into this universe again. There used to be a time about a week where I would be lurking, stalking. And big ups for the follow too, man. Big ups, Sanly. Oh, and again, you can go and try out the Ubisoft Plus thing. It's a free sub, man. You can try all these games. If you haven't played them, then go give them a shot. They're at least worth checking out for free, in any case. Oh, he's playing Monster Hunter. I never really gave that game a try.
What do you need to get your parachute?
I need 550 radar looking things.
Do you have any skill points?
Yes, I have 3.
Alright, so let's find you.
Guys?
Let's get into this area.
What the fuck happened?
Oh, wow. That was a moment, bro. It was a gamer moment. And this is the... That's the new game, right? Riders Republic. Which is fantastic because you can have a bunny helmet and snowboard and also do all that other stuff. Oh, can we get the Wings gameplay, this Wings of Redemption plane?
Be patient! What are you gonna do? You don't turn
the dude is camping, look at him! Wow, good fucking job, man. Good job. This was an MLG type situation. He sweeped everybody. And oh yeah, I love Trackmania, man. Trackmania is great. I am a fake gamer, but I do like this game. And of course, I am just as good as this guy. It actually might be a little bit better. Yeah, I would finish this not backwards. I would probably finish with my car straightforward.
Oh, you're not the bad guy. Oh, you're the bad guys.
What?
Man, I'm trying to be really.
Dude,
oh
what a great
God,
moment!
The farmer just ran over
Far Cry
the
just being Far Cry with the terrible AI and the terrible NPCs. Yeah, I do have a Cade boner for Far Cry. This was a cool move though, the cool one. Roller Champions. I think this is a pretty decent game. I haven't tried it. Probably never will. And the crew too. Let's see him. Is he gonna pull a? Wow. Wow. All right. Okay. That's impressive. That's probably one of the most impressive things from this highlight reel. And we got 40 seconds more. I didn't get myself a drink, but that is because I'll do it later probably. Okay. This guy's about to be bussing. Big ups, UK Dan, for the follow, man. Big ups. Shout out to you.
All right, that's all the updates we had for you on the pre-show.
And
you
Jordan said, DK.
Oh, I sure do.
Big ups.
All
that was like a double follow, like
can
a double
them
kill.
Free on PC starting right now for a month on Ubisoft Plus.
Oh, it's only on PC. But
free.
Yeah, because the sub is only on PC.
Just yet. It's time for our main show. You won't want to miss this. So let's kick things off.
Let's not miss it.
Get the party started.
Let's get the party started. Alright, banger alert, we're getting the party started. It's probably not gonna be the most exciting thing ever, but we're gonna see a new Assassin's Creed, so at least that's something. At least that's gonna happen.
Hi everybody, thank you so much for tuning in to the September edition of Ubisoft Forward.
Yo, they're in the desert now.
Taste of all the great things we're cooking up.
Insane.
I'm one of your hosts, Neelam Kumar.
I'm Yusuf Magid, and I'm so happy to be here today because this year we're global, streaming in no less than 11 different languages. So a big hello.
Probably no Splinter Cell, man.
We're
probably
also live
not.
In 4 sign languages and 2 audio descriptions. So we got you all covered.
Okay, yo, you are super accessible. Now stop
studio.
Harassing people. Let's start the show.
Time now. Come a long way from being intern.
And I don't mean you guys harassing people. Hey. You're probably some of the nicer people that work there.
But let's get to the real reason why we're here today, games. If you caught the Ubisoft Forward pre-show, you should already be caught up on some super exciting updates from current releases. And now, in the next few minutes, we'll show you what you can expect from our live and upcoming games, concluding with a very special Assassin's Creed showcase.
Also, the Assassin's Creed stuff is going to be at the end.
Well, hello everyone. Stay tuned for the Assassin's Creed showcase.
Hey, it's these guys, remember? Sean and
the 50th anniversary of this amazing franchise, I forgot. The future of Assassin's Creed.
Rebecca? What was her name? I don't know. Just two characters that used to appear in Assassin's Creed games.
But we also wanted to remind you that right now, you're all eligible for a free month subscription of Ubisoft Plus, giving you access to some of our best games. For more information, check the details on the screen below. And now,
sure
onto the
thing.
Games.
Go get it.
That's right.
Go, go,
what
go.
What a better way to start the show than by diving straight into the
colorful world. Why are people in chat saying Andrew
and
Tate? This dude doesn't look like Andrew Tate, man.
Is set to release on October 20th on Nintendo Switch.
Man.
Before we catch up with the game's creator,
maybe he should
bust
some moves.
Let's take a quick look.
Drop some moves, dude. Come on. Show us you're not Andrew Tate. And first we get rabbits, because, of course, that's the most pop-in franchise they got. The hypest franchise. It's Mario Rabbids. Let's go. This is it. I'm feeling the vibes. Super fresh, super cool.
Hello, everyone. A few months ago, we gave you an exclusive on Mario plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope, showcasing the game's unique mix of turn-based combat, real-time action, and open exploration. We also did a deep dive on our unique team of heroes.
Okay, doesn't somebody from the marketing department like have the ability to speak fluent English? Because this dude is kind of, I understand, but it's still, it's kind of hard.
So today we are back to show you, for the very first time, a first look at one of the quests from the game.
All right, now is when I'm gonna go for a drink.
A special battle that we took great
pleasure in crafting. I'm gonna need it, you guys. I'm gonna need it. I should have even got an energy drink from the supermarket, but I didn't go. So I'm kind of fucked. I'm not gonna leave midstream.
Faye, associate producer. Welcome to this new video about Mario plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope. Today, our heroes travel to Terra Flora in their quest
to save
the Sparks.
All right, enjoy this. I'll be right back.
This green and usually flowery planet is struck by a drought caused by Cursa's malevolent influence. To help the planet blossom again, Mario and his friends must reach the top of the volcano. To get there, they will have to find their way to the central station and take the Wiggler train. Terra Flora, like all the planets of Mario plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope, is packed with secrets, collectibles to gather, puzzles to solve, and wacky NPCs to talk with. With the help of people, heroes can interact with the environment in various ways to uncover secrets or reveal hidden paths to new zones. There are many interesting places to visit and secrets to discover on Terra Flora. Giant trees, lush plains, and hidden caves. But let's get back on track. We have a train to catch. Enraged by Cursa, and we must stop it before it destroys the train. Mario and his friends will face numerous enemy archetypes on the battlefield, each with specific strengths and weaknesses. We need to prepare accordingly. Let's pick Bowser first. His huge health stats will allow him to sustain heavy damage. Rabbit Rosalina's signature technique will be key to neutralize enemies while the other heroes focus on the Darkness Eyes. We'll keep Mario and the team to take advantage of his great mobility skills. Now, the sparks. There are dozens of sparks you can pair with your heroes. They will grant elemental damage, resistances, help control battlefield, and much more. Gathering will help Rabbit Rosalina getting behind enemy lines to wreak havoc.
What in the Pokemon is this?
We're done prepping.
Alright, I'm
now
back,
is
but this is
fight.
Some kind of strange,
Mario's
suspicious stuff,
Aquinox
man.
To gain additional
it's
splash
weird
damage.
Content.
Thanks to the splash effect,
and of course, their
Mario
chat
can
is super
the
toxic.
Out of the train.
They're all like
Why?
Sleeping.
Destroy the electric barrel with his
but that's your average live event chat.
Rabbit
kind of
Rosalina
do,
can finish the Ooze off. While Bowser takes advantage of the large attack radius of his Bowsuka to destroy
Bowsuka,
two Darkness Eyes at the same time.
This dude is serious.
Fast
the
forward.
Bowsuka.
New enemies are spawning behind us. We must
Make
get
him pull out the BK-47.
Let's use Mario's Spark Glitter to lure those enemies out into the open before triggering Mario's signature ability, Hero Sight.
Bro, can we skip through this? Can we like vote to skip?
It's time for Bowser to get his revenge.
I mean, alright, probably somebody's into this.
His
I'm not gonna be like salty about it,
combined
but
combined with the devastating power of Zephyr,
come on, this
Shockwave Spark
probably shouldn't
and
be that long.
Sport Fire will make short work of this group of enemies.
But anyways, this is gonna be like a 2-hour event, so
teamwork and synergies
it's not
are
that
key
bad
to gain the
end.
Upper hand in battle. That the back of the train is clear, we must reach the locomotive to destroy the Darkness Eyes on the Wiggler's back. This won't be easy, as the Lone Wolves will react by shooting any moving hero coming into range. They inflict heavy damage to Bowser. Thankfully, Exosphere, his shield spark, absorbs some of the damage. Brute Force won't make it here. It's time for a stealthy move with Rabbit Rosalina. Her spark, Aethering, can turn her invisible, allowing her to approach the Lone Wolf safely. Now that we are close to them, we can use her signature technique and neutralize them momentarily. This will allow Mario to approach safely and focus on the Darkness Eyes.
Hey, I was muted this whole time. That's great.
A few more turns.
It's the first Twitch mute.
Only two Darkness Eyes.
But anyways,
remain.
I was just
but
saying that it's, if they made
Bowser
one before that or at least a few before
attacks.
That, then it's probably like somebody would care.
And the last Darkness
Not
eyes
that stream chat that I'm
range.
Watching right now. Those dudes don't care, but of course they're there for the assassin stuff.
Stomp attack.
That's why this goes first.
From one enemy to the other before delivering the final blow. This is it. The Wiggler is defeated, and our heroes can resume their journey. I hope you enjoyed this very special battle. That's all for now.
Alright, next.
I hope you also enjoyed seeing an old friend from Nintendo in there. This was only a first taste of our new take on combat. It has intuitive gameplay with huge tactical possibilities. Thanks to the multiple combination of sparks and ingredients available in the game, anyone can create combos as marvelous as they are powerful. The release is almost there, and we are hard at work to polish our game and deliver the best Mario plus Rabbids experience on October 20.
Hey, the dude actually
we
made it a point to say that they're polishing the
to
game.
To discover this brand new adventure.
So yeah, respect to you,
and
man.
And that's not all. We have one more big thing to reveal. This cosmic journey will not stop at launch. We have so many wild ideas that we want to explore in the coming year. It is a bit early to announce all
of it.
Also,
it's a roadmap.
But I couldn't resist to give you a small peek
of
what is to come.
Of course.
Our post-launch plans include 3 DLCs, and the third one will even introduce a new special playable hero. For me, as a creator, and for many at the studio, it's a dream come true to have him going in an adventure with our dear Rabbit Heroes.
They're gonna put Ezio in there.
You will like the
it's
biggest
be Ezio.
Surprise of
our
what
a massive surprise!
Pass.
It's Ezio. Thank you. Or Sam Fisher. They're gonna put Sam Fisher going on an adventure with rabbits. Rabbits 3, a splintered cell. Man. Huh? Oh, it's Rayman. Yeah, Rayman. Yeah.
I love the rabbits and I love the world of Mario, and I'm so glad to see them teaming up once again. Davide is so passionate about what he creates, and I can't wait to play as Rayman on my team in this new DLC adventure.
If you like what you just saw and want to dive into
the conversation.
The
most corporate line I've ever heard anybody say. Like, I didn't believe this dude for like a split second that he's excited for this game. Not a split second.
Launch.
Let's take a deep dive into the world of Skull and Bones.
Oh, Skull and Bones. Let's get to see this. This is very controversial because it's been in development since like 1965. They announced it back in like a million years ago. So let's okay, I'm gonna shut up for this. Let's check it out.
With an iron fist, they ignited a battle for global supremacy to dominate the world's most valuable trade routes. A flood of exotic goods from the Indian Ocean stormed the West, creating new addictions and a violent race for control. And where there's blood, there are predators. Labeled as enemies of all mankind, this new breed of pirates will show no mercy.
Okay, it's a cinematic trailer. Can't say I'm super impressed, but let's get to the actual trailer. Actual gameplay.
Built their pirate empires. But they were always on the edge of losing it all. And sink into the depths of Skull and Bones.
Will you sink to the bottom or climb to the very top? In the dangerous world of Skull and Bones, everything around you is either your prey or your downfall.
What?
This is where you and your friends will
pirate?
Have an authentic pirate experience. In our game, as your infamy begins to spread across the Indian Ocean, you will gain access to your own pirate lair, known as the Helm. Here, you'll kickstart your ascent as a pirate kingpin by manufacturing and smuggling illegal and high-value goods to sell to the highest bidder.
Oh,
no longer taking orders from other pirates, you'll now be the one calling the shots. But with all the riches now for you taking, you'll also have more to lose. So beware. The vultures are circling, biding their time to strike you down. Will you fend off pirate rogues eyeing your cargo as you strike your contraband, or undone rivals who want a piece of your pie? Maybe you'll plunder forts for their stockpiles and flood the black markets, or even go on treasure hunts to dig up valuable hidden stashes. We've been gathering your feedbacks through our insider programs and other channels. It's an ongoing process that helps us shape Skull
and Bones. Is that why they changed the core mechanics like 4 times?
Participants
is that why the game in development hell?
Greetings, pirates. Captain Flint here.
My name's Sam, more commonly known as Mr. Stainless.
I'm Bill Dane.
I'm Fuzzy Bond.
My name is Spam.
Wait, are these people playing the game already?
Charging Charlie.
Crispy Tater Tot.
Charging Charlie.
I joined the Skull and Bones Insider Program back in 2021.
I've actually been part of the Insider Program ever since its inception.
I've sailed, plundered, and pillaged my way way through multiple testing and feedback sessions.
The playtests that I've
been
doing.
Why did they all record it in 9x16?
One of the things
why not an actual like normal
streamlined feedback actually reaching the developers.
The developers are passionate about this game.
I get to connect with other gamers who are just as passionate and excited about Skull and Bones as I am.
So you're trying to tell me to buy it, huh?
Revealed again.
I'm so excited.
You're gonna ask me to pre-order, maybe?
I look forward to seeing your sales out there.
I truly think there's something for everyone, so I'm really eager to see all the polish and final versions of things brought into the game.
I just can't wait to see all the Indian Ocean.
Oops, they said
really
polish, guys.
To seeing all of you out on the high seas, be it friend or foe.
Look, no, I'm not buying this. And I mean, not just purchasing it, I'm not buying this fairy tale.
But Barrett's work
this game
has
been in development hell for a while.
So will our game. As in the pirate tales of old, you will always find a ship at the center of the story. One so terrifying that most will flee on sight. That is what we want for our pirates. Your ship is your entire world. It is where your success will be decided and how you will be recognized. In Skull and Bones, to build a unique ship that inspires fear onto your enemies, there are three steps. Step one, pick your weapons and ammo. This will make or break your battles. From piercing ammo that ignores armor and causes flooding,
the weapons can
tearing
make or
ammo
break
that
battle,
rips
you
your enemy's sails apart, slowing them down for an easy kill. My favorite is crushing as it deals a devastating blow to most armor. Step two, choose your armor. With our game's weapon counter system, there will be an armor that can counter each damage type. That's how we keep tension high at sea. Lastly,
all right, so it's rock,
it's
paper,
a look of your ship. Put on your
thing.
Scariest war paint and head out with a ship that is instantly recognizable. Making this quick adjustment will transform you from sneaky smuggler to hard-hitting hunters or swift traders.
Yeah,
now,
this wouldn't be how it would work if you're an actual pirate, though. You can't just morph your ship. Back. At will.
In our PvVP world, you can choose to switch off PvP to prevent any friendly fire as
well. Oh, hell yeah.
Lastly, our game will be crossplay at launch, so you can pirate with your friends no matter what platform they are on. Ultin Zen, bon voyage, and see you all soon on the seas of Skull and Bones.
Wait, that was it? That was the Skull and Bones preview?
The greatest heist ever.
Yo, this is the most suspicious game of all time. Of all time. Since, like, Cyberpunk. Mega suspicious. And now we're getting a fabricated gameplay trailer.
Kali will play the villain.
And we got a bunch of dudes that played the game that are telling you, dude, this game is amazing. I can't wait for you to play it. Very suspicious. Very, very suspicious.
Gird your loins.
And it doesn't make it much easier when I could barely understand what the lady was saying. But okay, so what we got from this, you can change your weapons kind of at any time. You can turn off the PvP, it's crossplay. And, yeah, basically, what else? Oh yeah, the ammo types and the weapon types is kind of like rock, paper, scissors, because they cancel each other out. So you gotta pick the good ones. But very suspicious, man. 8th of November, and this is what we get as a gameplay reveal? 8th of November!
Oof, Milne, I can't wait to get in my own pirate ship, explore
the
Indian
Ocean.
Oh, dude,
yeah, the dude is mega excited about everything. He can't wait every single game.
It's out of love. It's out of love.
Skull and Bones were released this year on Xbox Series, PS5, and PC. All right, we're on to the next title.
Riders Republic is our massively multiplayer outdoor sports game.
Get him out of here.
Players mountain bike, snowboard, ski, and wingsuit in epic races and awesome freestyle events. But you know what, Neil? Just when you thought it couldn't
in
get
microtransactions.
Any better, we've added an exciting piece of
and
new
cool
content.
Outfits. And Fortnite. Yeah, but that is true. Sea of Thieves was bare bones, but they also got a lot of flack for that. It was a pretty big controversy how bare bones that game was. And it took them like, I don't know, like 2 years for them to actually go back to a state where people were happy about it. Oh, we got BMX coming to Riders Republic. Well, that's not bad. Get a new map. Ooh, wow, that is interesting, man. It looks kind of like Tony Hawk Pro Skater type of level, where it's just like over the top, goofy, and silly. I'm still AD, never forget. All right, nice. I'm not gonna play this, but I can't say it looks too bad. Get new tricks. Right, we got brand collabs and the more. And we get kind of a Doja Cat song, but it's not Doja Cat. Alright, season 4 freestyling. Play free now. Wow, it's free again. Unless they made it free, like.
Riders Republic season 4 free. And the BMX add-on free, launches free. In just 4 days on September 14th. And guess what? You can play Riders Republic for free on all platforms. Details are below.
Well, I don't
now
know,
it's
man.
Time to put the spotlight on one of our most successful
sounds
online
good,
action
man.
Role-playing
it's free.
Games.
Yep, it's time to catch up on the world of Tom Clancy's The Division.
The Division. Let's
check
it out.
Hello, everyone. I'm Daria Ilina, community developer for Tom Clancy The Division 2. After more than 3 years, Tom Clancy The Division 2 is still releasing new content, and we have exciting times ahead. To recap, Season 9, Hidden Alliance brought you so much more.
They're
going to
make the health bars bigger.
Story. We introduced Countdown, a new 8-layer PV endgame mode.
It's going to take you 5 more magazines to take somebody down.
Giving you new ways to progress your agent and further increase build variety and viability. And it's not over. The Division 2 is scheduled to receive 2 more major updates this year, Season 10 and Season 11. You will be able to enjoy Season 10 Price Power in just a few days. It will introduce additional difficulty modes for Countdown to push your squad to the limit, add an array of long-awaited quality of life changes, and set you on the path to uncover the growing alliance between Natalia Sokolova and General Anderson. And when
Wait,
it comes
what?
To ensuring your agent
Girl,
looks the best,
you're Russian. You can say
hunt,
it properly. You don't need to say Natalia Sokolova. You can say it properly. Your name is Daria. Come on. You know how it's pronounced.
To close out 2022 for The Division 2,
Sokolova
Season
bled.
11 will continue The Division story, not only introducing new Manhunt targets, but also some familiar faces and a new ally. It will also feature a brand new PvE mode, expanding the variety of activities and playability in the game. We'll share more details about all these features later this year. Now we want to reiterate our commitment to the long-term future of The Division 2. Which is fully supported by our talented developers from Ubisoft teams across the globe. With this in mind, we're happy to announce that we are committed to and have started working on The Division Year 5. The future is bright for The Division 2
okay.
and for The Division
cool.
franchise
oh,
as a whole.
It's
now,
free, you guys.
I'll
Go check it out.
Now I'll hand over to Carrie to introduce you to Tom Clancy The Division's Heartland.
Over the last few years, the team
is
at Red Storm Entertainment has been hard at work creating an all-new experience
Ubisoft
set in the world
Red
of The Division.
Storm. God
You've
damn.
Already rebuilt operations in Manhattan. You've responded to the call in Washington, D.C.
Oh, this was,
and now you're needed in the small town of Silver Creek, right in the heartland
this
of
like
America.
A,
Today, we're excited to share a first look
like
at the
a
game
battle royale?
And some updates from our studio.
Oh, we're going to see a first
Here's
look.
Here's our creative
all
director,
right.
Keith Evans, to tell you a little bit on what to expect in The Division Heartland.
Hey everyone, we're so excited to show you Heartland, an all-new standalone adventure in the Division universe. The teams poured their heart into this game, and we can't wait to
Did
share it with you.
Did they pour their land as well?
Welcome to Silver Creek.
I'm so fucking funny, man. Welcome to Silver Creek.
I'm Keith
Creek.
Evans, creative director in Heartland at Red Storm Entertainment. We've been involved here at Red Storm with the Division going back before the first game launched. Our partnership with Massive Entertainment made some games that we love. We're so excited to bring something new to fans of the franchise. Heartland's a free-to-play survival action shooter set in the Division universe that features streamlined survival gameplay and a beautiful new world to explore.
Oh, yeah.
You play as a Division agent, given the task of protecting Silver Creek, a small town in Middle America, from enemy factions, rogue agents, and a deadly contamination. This game ties directly into the timeline and introduces all new characters and storylines to the franchise. Heartland
no,
feels fresh
who cares
and distinct
about the fucking
while still
Division
feeling at home
story.
Alongside the other
Come
amazing
on.
Games in this universe. We can't wait to have you join us in Silver Creek.
So it's wait. So it's a battle royale.
Follow the official Division social channels to learn more about the journey the team has taken and the important role of player feedback in the evolution of the Heartland experience.
Player feedback.
Register
get them out of here.
Upcoming tests at thedivisionheartland.com.
Player feedback.
Finally,
the company that always makes fucking games that people were complaining about for years.
Resurgence.
They're gonna make
this
the same
one. This brings the acclaimed AAA experience to mobile with the addition of a new storyline,
factions, of course, we're
and
on mobile.
Much more.
Is this
the team
what
is hard
people
at work
requested?
Preparing what comes next, so it is our great pleasure to be able to give you an update on the game. We wanted to take a moment to thank everyone who has participated in the closed alpha, playing solo or cooperating with others to complete a taste of the game's unique campaign and open world activities.
Your feedback has been priceless as we keep fine-tuning and improving the game. Today, we're happy to announce that a closed beta test is coming this fall.
It's a closed beta.
This will be an opportunity
you
to play the iconic conflict PvP modes, and for the first time on mobile.
Please subscribe to this channel. Make me one of those dudes that get into the closed beta, and I'm gonna leak all the secrets. I'm gonna tell only you. Only this channel is gonna get it. This is how this is gonna become the number one channel on Twitch. I guess the Division Resurgence. What is this? Oh, the mobile thing. All right, let's see it. Let's get to see it. Enter the Dark Zone. Remember the Dark Zone? It was real fun, man. And now you get to do it with children on your phone. That's real fun. But for real, though, it's not a bad idea. It's the Division on mobile. If you don't have a console or a good PC, you can play it on your phone. So yeah, it's still something. I sure hope your screen can fill up all those health bars, though. There's a lot of health bars, and they're very, very big. Playing co-op though. Well, I mean, all right. It's a mobile thing. Closed beta coming. So yeah, you can kind of see the gameplay. It's about.
We're super excited to see the Dark Zone
what
coming.
What you
to
would expect?
If you want to get a chance to test it out, don't forget to register now on the Resurgence website.
Oof, sure. I want that sweet, sweet multiplayer
Bro,
action.
Bro, this
the
dude
online.
Is the biggest fucking gamer of all time, man. He loves everything. He's so excited about everything.
Rainbow Six Mobile.
It's almost a
Let's
little bit hard to take him seriously. And now we get Rainbow Six Mobile.
Closed alpha test.
So Winx can play it while he's in the bathroom or something. He's definitely going to do that. That's not even like a joke. That's a reality waiting to happen. Except if he streams himself from the bathroom. That you don't want to see that. You can't handle that. There's not a bitrate high enough that can broadcast that. But anyways, here is the game that you know and love, but on your phone this time. So your mom can call you that the dinner is ready, and she can ruin your clutch. And then people are gonna call you the N-word because you fucked it up. Oh man, I love Splinter Cell, Rainbow Six. Oh, I exposed myself as a fake gamer.
Hello everyone, I'm Justin Swan, creative director of Rainbow Six Mobile. It's been a big.
Do we need the creative director for the game to come out so they can tell us is the game that we already know about for like 10 years, but this time on your phone?
Our players and community reacted to the game, and we couldn't be happier with the initial feedback.
And
Rainbow
course,
Six
feedback.
Mobile is a free-to-play game designed from the ground up specifically for mobile devices.
When they we told started production, to shill the word feedback clear. Over and over again. Hey, what's up, Jim Bean? Welcome.
Platform.
Welcome. We're looking at Rainbow Six Mobile right now. It's super exciting.
Enjoy this competitive, tactical,
Are you not
and
excited?
Team-based FPS experience. Our mission is to develop the best Rainbow Six experience possible on mobile, and we can only do that with your help. The dev team and I first want to thank our community for all your support and feedback during our closed alpha. We took that feedback to heart.
Do you not have gameplay testers? Do you not have people that actually are paid to play the game and to find the bugs? Stop rambling about fucking feedback. Ubisoft is not known for caring about feedback. They delete Reddit comments and all kinds of comments. Come on.
I'm very happy to announce that we are entering a new phase for Rainbow Six Mobile, the beta test. The closed beta starts this Monday, September 12th.
Again.
And the good news is that Android users can still pre-register on Google Play for a chance to participate. Just a quick note for our iOS users, don't worry. We are working hard on our iOS version. You will hear from us in the near future for upcoming tests. So, what can you expect to see in the game during the beta test?
One platform?
Our biggest addition is the first stage of our operator unlock and progression system. This means daily challenges to complete, a ticket system to play with and unlock your operators, and even a battle pass to progress
gems.
Through.
Oh yeah, of
on
course
top of
a
that,
battle pass.
We have
pass.
Some great graphical and gameplay improvements, social features like voice chat and persistent teams, and a more streamlined menu flow. You will also be able to compete in three iconic Rainbow Six maps: Bank, Border, and the newly added Clubhouse. Keep in mind, this is still a work in progress version
maps,
of the game.
Honestly.
Graphic quality and content are much improved from our alpha test, but still not
I
final.
I prefer the other one.
As we continue along this exciting road to release, we must move forward alongside you, our players and fans. We believe this is the only way to deliver the best game experience possible, and we are dedicated to developing Rainbow Six Mobile in as transparent and collaborative way as possible with our players. Now, you may be wondering in which countries the closed beta will be available starting this Monday. Well, you'll find the answers in this next video. Thank you for all your support, and see you in the closed beta.
Can't we just get like a photo of all the countries? And then people would just see their country. Oh, we're getting a reveal video. The game you know and love, just in low res.
It's
and on your phone.
Day.
Ready to breach. People are gonna tear this event a new asshole. Man, they're gonna hate on it so bad. If I go on Twitter, it's gonna be this stream chat, but like a million times over and over again. Because this is just one of the greediest, worst companies making mobile games out of their biggest properties. And that's just been, so far, that's been most of it. In a really underwhelming Skull and Bones reveal, which is not even a reveal, it's kind of just like a little bit of like info. Re-register for a chance to play the beta. Oh no, it's not over. There's a lot more to go. But this is just judging by the opening and everything so far, it's really underwhelming.
The Rainbow Six Mobile closed beta starts on September 12th.
Here at Ubisoft, we're developing some world-class partnerships.
Are you excited
with some
for
very
it?
Big
Dude,
players in the industry.
You didn't say
Here's
you're excited
a little
for
bit
it.
More about it is a very
Makes me think
guest.
That you hate it.
Hi, I'm Mike Verdu from Netflix.
Oh, Netflix.
As you know, we've started to offer a selection of mobile games on our service.
Of course.
And today, I'm excited to announce
get him out of
our
there.
Partnership with
we're
Ubisoft.
We're going to be shilling fucking Netflix games.
Great games for players all around the world. Over the next few years, not one, not two, but three games from Ubisoft's most beloved franchises
are going to come on Netflix
will become exclusively
gaming.
Available to Netflix members. The first game is Valiant Hearts
Yo.
2, a sequel to the award-winning first
Stop
game,
it.
Directed by the original core
Stop
team
it.
And available to play in
Netflix gaming. Netflix gaming.
Next up,
remember
the second
this?
Installment of Mighty Quest, also coming to Netflix in 2023.
No, stop it.
And last, but certainly not least, fans of Assassin's Creed will be able to immerse themselves in the Assassin's Creed universe
on Netflix
through both a live action series and an original mobile game.
No, it's not
we'll
even like Google Stadia or Stadia. It's literally for mobile games. Like it's Google Play basically, but on Netflix. It's so bad. And it's been existing for probably the last year or two.
And we're looking forward
Get
to bringing
this.
These great
Netflix
games
gaming,
to existing and
right?
new fans alike.
Netflix gaming. This existed like
Ubisoft
since
and Netflix.
Like 20
now
months.
That's
Look at this.
To celebrate.
August 22, all the games. And this is
the
type of stuff
shows
they
how
offer.
Video games have grown.
It's literally just
we don't
mobile
just play
games.
Them. We make movies based on them. Sometimes
Into the Breach.
TV
we got Into the Breach
them.
On Netflix.
And on that
games.
Note, let's take a sneak peek
these,
at season 3
things.
Of Mythic Quest.
Anyways.
Hello, everyone at Ubisoft.
Oh, and we got Rob
McElhenney. I'm Rob McElhenney, writer, co-creator, and star
of Mythic Quest on Apple TV Plus. For those of you who've seen the show, we can't wait for you to watch season 3.
For those of you who haven't seen Mythic Quest, the membership.
This is the series
for
you.
No, the follow, actually.
It's a show about a fake gaming company making a fake game, but produced by a real gaming company that makes real game elements for our fake game. Not to mention, we have actors like Ashley Birch, who are real gaming professionals, even though they play fake characters.
Okay.
You
also own a football club.
Teaser for season 3
with Ryan Reynolds, which is very funny.
I just did. And in case you're wondering, no,
because he doesn't know the offside rule.
You don't need any new gear to watch Apple TV Plus. You can literally watch it on the same gaming console you play on. Hope you enjoy.
This is where the magic happens.
And this literally a plug for a TV show.
Our legacy.
Our legacy. Whatever.
It's not my legacy.
Where are we with these?
But I haven't watched it, so I'm not gonna diss it too much.
We'll get you into programming school.
Local. MQ will pay for it.
I think I gotta go to Berkeley.
Yeah, that's impossible.
No more Mr. Nice Guy. Go ahead and cuff me.
Oh, and they got this guy.
We're leaving you and Mythic Quest.
No. Yes.
No.
Yes.
Yes. Now, let's talk about our future.
And this used to be on, I think, Apple TV. Oh, yeah, it's
this
an Apple original.
Yes. We really did it!
Yes.
We just $50 million!
No.
What?
We're not gonna take the money.
No.
Yes.
I'm glad you're back.
You know, as janitor, I see a lot of things.
But you have nothing to worry about. There's nothing, like, strange or nefarious going on.
And even if there was, you'd never know it.
Sorry, wait, what?
Are you into the metaverse?
Hell no.
Oh, he did a wait what joke.
Poppy,
wait,
where are you?
You're the one that didn't
these are always great, you guys.
Lines are so web one. You don't want to be in web one, do you? You gotta think big.
What? She taking like ADHD medication?
Everyone stop sneaking up on me.
I've been standing here alone for the last 20 minutes.
We're explorers.
Innovators.
Bro, so it's like I haven't watched this show, but I want to skip it already.
What matters is what you believe about yourself.
This is the heir of Brittlesby.
What the?
Where are the buttons?
Hello?
No buttons anywhere.
Help! Every morning there's a halo.
Very good.
Every morning there's a halo.
I really love Mythic Quest. I'm so happy the show got renewed for a season 3.
Same here. Whether you've played every Ubisoft game in existence or more of a casual fan, there's something for everyone here at Ubisoft Forward.
Which brings us to a very special offer that we definitely haven't referenced before. Check this out.
What is the
what
Ubisoft Plus is free?
Ubisoft makes the games you know and love. And that's only the beginning of
even
so
he, even
much
he joked
more.
With it.
It is all the Assassin's Creed
even
Creed
he
titles.
Joked with it.
Even jump into competitive shooters to test your skills and your patience. Team up for co-op and tactical games where the only way forward is to get.
I mean, well, it's free. It's free. And it's probably no commitment, so you can just go and play like a Far Cry 6 or something for like 30 hours and then drop it and that's it. And you lose nothing. Plus, it's a Saturday. Just go and check it out if you care about it. And you can play Uno. Look at this. And Monopoly. It's insanely good, man. It's such value for free.
Ubisoft only made open worlds?
Guess so.
And guess what? Try it all for free starting now
until October 10th.
Hours and hours of gameplay.
Wait, what? That's for an actual month, though. That's very nice.
Available day one.
Oh, you think they're gonna shill the quartz? I completely forgot about the quartz, man. I really hope they don't bring that up. If they bring that up, I'm gonna lose my shit. I think they gave up on it. Because everyone hated it. Everyone, like actually everyone.
Details as
and
always,
they wanted to put it in their worst actual game, which was Ghost Recon Breakpoint. They wanted to put it in that.
Sign up right now.
And next everybody was like, no, no. And then they didn't. I think they did, really but it flopped immediately. Anyways, what are we seeing now? A Ubisoft original. Not Prince of oh, it's Trackmania, okay. Thanks for the spoilers. Big ups, Curtis Hulbert Art, dude. Big ups for the follow, man. Hope you make some cool art. Let's hop in the Trackmania.
gentlemen, the race is about to begin.
Okay, let's see what this is going to be about. This is probably not a new Trackmania, but maybe some DLC, maybe some update. Maybe some, I don't know. Oh, VR, yeah, maybe VR. Yeah, that would be a, that's a good point. This in VR is insane, man. This would give me like night terrors. Okay. Welcome to the club. Oh no, it's just a new game, I guess. Trackmania TM? Is this supposed to be a TM?
Hello, everyone. So. I'm Augustin De Vita, producer on Trackmania at Ubisoft Nadeo. To the excitement of its 10 million fans, Trackmania is back on consoles and streaming platforms early 2023. And the first bit of good news is that crossplay and cross-progression will be available across all platforms. PS4, PS5, Xbox One, Xbox Series, Stadia, and Luna.
Luna?
Trackmania is free to play with no microtransaction. But we do offer two premium access that unlock even more social and community features. You will still experience that same adrenaline rush on extraordinary tracks, be it solo or online with hundreds of live opponents. We have lots of features to keep you racing. There's a new seasonal official campaign every 3 months, esports events like the Cup of the Day with thousands of players, the Track of the Day which highlights our players' creativity, and you can team up with your friends to play in the Royal or Ranked game modes. And that's not all. Trackmania is the best place for creators to unlock their full imagination. With its industry-leading and powerful track editor, featuring thousands of blocks and items. After its PC launch 2 years ago, the game is stronger than ever, with 280,000 tracks created by players worldwide. The great news is that these tracks will be available from day one on the console and cloud versions.
All right.
With Trackmania Clubs, we are offering deep social features within the game. With car skin customization, private rooms, as well as campaigns and competitions organized by the players for the players.
Oh yeah, he got that accent.
We're looking forward to reuniting the
Ubisoft
accent community in one single world, no matter where and how you play.
Like the
early 2023.
Like the Skull and Bones lady. She got that thick accent.
I love me some Trackmania.
Oh,
I can't wait to hop online and play against all.
This dude is like the biggest gamer ever.
Well, that was unnecessary. moving on. Let's jam out to our next release.
It's for Rocksmith Plus,
jam
right?
Oh, sure is, Neelam.
Oh,
if you've
Rocksmith.
Ever dreamed of learning the guitar, Rocksmith Plus is for you.
Let's see. Rocksmith is dope. Let's see this one. And copyrighted music. Eh? Yeah, I wish I enjoyed gaming as much as this guy. Even nearly as much, man. The dude loves everything. And they just showed a bunch of, like, a bunch of Ubisoft games, and dude was like, man, I'm so excited for every single one. And I work for this company. All right, how are we gonna evolve? How? Rocksmith Plus. Didn't they advertise this last year as well? And basically said nothing about it? Oh, and you can play wireless, which is a really bad idea, because it's not going to be accurate at all. Or maybe you're going to have like an adapter that goes in your guitar, probably. Because they did have that custom cable for the first one.
I feel like Rocksmith Plus is the perfect tool to get me started.
Well, if you're going to learn guitar, you should also practice your dance moves.
You mean these dance moves?
How could I forget?
Yo.
For those of you like tearing it up
Yo,
on the dance floor
no.
like Yusuf,
what
our
fuck?
Next
Stop.
Game is right up your
Stop
alley.
Emoting.
This year, get ready to step into
the
new
dude is glitched.
Era of Just Dance.
Stop
Let's
it.
Let's check out all the exciting surprises the
Andrew
team's been
Tate,
working
stop
on.
It. What? Dude forgot to turn off the emotes. What a great segment, man. And now we're on Just Dance. Hold on, that was all for Rocksmith? They just said, hey, Rocksmith exists. Come back next year. Maybe I'm gonna play this on Twitch, you guys. Make sure to follow the channel for me to play Just Dance. Do a bunch of Fortnite dances on camera. Alright.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric wavy when I turn it on. Cause I got that.
Yo, I'm gonna get a panic attack from this. What is happening? What the fuck? And we're dancing to like a 6-year-old song, man. When it Can't Stop the Feeling came out. Can't Stop the Feeling. Isn't it like a 2017 song? God damn it. 2016! Come on! Come on! Give me a break. That's a good question, Curtis. Why do they do this cringe shit? Because they're very much out of touch. Because they're being ran by a bunch of like 60-year-old dudes that are molesting people nonstop.
I'm the producer on Just Dance.
And I am Matthew Tumkinson.
And the people
director.
That organize these events, they're not gamers. They're just marketing execs, marketing people, and just people that are out of touch.
Offers you an instant mood boost, a sense of community, a creative outlet, or a way to stay active.
And there are people like Devolver Digital that own up to the memes, and they know how to play with the memes and how to be trendy and hip. But Ubisoft never was those people. They don't know. They don't know.
Just Dance offers a renewed experience with a new art direction, user interface, and an optimized recommendation system that find playlists and songs that fit your every mood. We also invite you to discover brand new characters and follow them into immersive stories across rich visual and musical universes.
It's like you can say that, and I'm going to talk over this because it's Just Dance. You can say that gamers, they don't know what they want and they're never happy, but people, especially on the internet, are very outspoken with exactly what they want and exactly what they enjoy. And if you get a team of people to go and read a bunch of reviews and a bunch of like feedback from people, like actual genuine feedback, and pick apart what people have said and figure out what they want to have in their games, it's gonna work out. But they just actually don't care. Like, actually.
Online dance sessions. Let's check out this new mode together. Here is the new homepage of Just Dance, where you can discover all the activities the game has to offer. Let's welcome our Just Dancers. Hello, everyone. As you can see,
okay,
you will be
and
able
we're giving
to
way too much time for Just Dance. I guess it's a game that sells well.
And pick the songs you want to party along. Okay, let's jump into the song If You Wanna Party.
Okay, is this also a song from 2016? Maybe 2015? I mean, I don't know, man. I don't know. What is this supposed to be? Like, what am I supposed
Great
to look
job,
at this
everyone.
And be like, holy shit, this
Let's
is so exciting.
Take a look at the scores.
I wish I could do that.
And the winner is Elena.
Well
hey,
done, and
Elena.
One
The
one
new score results screen features the new
addict.
Detailed dancer cards. Of course, you will be able to personalize your own.
Thanks, everyone, for joining this session. The first one of many more to come. When you enter Just Dance, you will always have someone to play with, as you will join one united community gathered at the same place. We can't wait for you to get your hands on the game. We'll leave you with a first glimpse of some of the amazing songs of this year in the Just Dance 2023 edition. Goodbye.
Bye.
Oh yeah, speaking of this, iShowSpeed did some good moments with it. Just Dance, iShowSpeed, right? So you can see this was actually pretty fun. Because the dude is fun, he knows how to have fun with it. Right, and at some point I think he freaked out and like smashed his camera or something, I don't know. Anyways, let's go back to this entertainment. And you see, they show the songs, but they don't play them. Dua Lipa with Physical. There was Justin Bieber song, but yeah. Oh, this dude is still dancing.
Personally, I can't wait to play with all my friends around the world.
And of course, yes. He's super excited again. He's like the hype beast. Anyway, he's literally like the ideal Ubisoft consumer.
Wherever they are on the planet. As you might know, 15 years ago,
I'm so excited for all of this product.
With Assassin's Creed, we introduced the new gaming universe capable of transporting you back to the Crusades as Altair took assassinations to the next level.
All right, Assassin's Creed.
Thanks to you, 15 years later, the brand is more alive than ever.
This is why we created a deep dive into the world of Assassin's Creed to show you where the
brand is. Are you trying to tell me that this is the last segment?
We have surprises and announcements for you.
This is like the last thing?
Showcase like this, then our
really?
CEO, Yves Guillemot.
No Splinter Cell, no nothing. No, nothing actually interesting. A bunch of mobile stuff. And now we're showing
Hello,
like the Grandmaster Molester.
Thank you for joining us for this edition of Ubisoft Forward. I would like to congratulate all Ubisoft teams around the world for their tremendous work bringing these incredible games to life. And to all the players watching us, thank you for the passion you have for our games.
And
creating
for the money.
Memorable and unique experiences is what drives us every day. Speaking of passion for games, we are celebrating 15 years since the first Assassin's Creed. Altair, Ezio, Arno, Bayek, Cassandra, Eivor, many of you have lived memorable moments with these characters, making history your playground, learning, challenging yourself, and most importantly, having fun. With your support, Assassin's Creed went beyond a collection of games. It helped shape the face of the video game industry and became an inspiration for players and developers around the world. And now, let's see
at some point it stopped being about the games and started
universe.
Being about the actual brand and the visual language that it conveyed. Like somewhere around like Syndicate, the games were not in the forefront anymore. Let's see this nice CGI segment. All right, we got Connor, we got Ivor, we got Cassandra. This Ezio, the OG, original assassin, the OA, and a special logo. All right, so we begin this segment.
Are you ready for this? Of course you are. Come on, don't be shy. Don't let a fancy suit impress you.
It's
don't
like a weird
fancy suits
semi-live action
you.
Segment.
Be the thorn in history's side. Choose the greatest enemies. The captain. Sorry, mate. The emperor.
Why did he say sorry, mate?
The boss's boss.
What?
Requiescat in pace. And make even greater friends.
Decent work, Leonardo.
Don't just pick a fight. Start a revolution.
Why did they do this in live action? I'm baffled. They had so many good cinematics.
Go too far.
Because this looks like some bizarro cosplay.
Go too fast.
I mean, sure, man. Go
Face
for
the
it.
Invisible.
It's 15 years.
The impossible. The unspeakable. Welcome to the greatest playground. History.
Oh, and now we're setting up for Infinity. Like actual Assassin's Creed Infinity. Try for free with Ubisoft Plus.
Hello, everybody, and welcome along to the first ever Assassin's Creed showcase. It is time to leap into history. I'm Danny Wallace
Butts,
here
dude.
In our top
welcome
secret hideout,
to the
where
channel
I'll be bringing you some sneak peeks, special guests, and sharing
right
some
on time
very
for the Assassin's
exciting
Creed
updates
show-off.
On all things Assassin's Creed. You will not want to miss this. Today, I am joined by a true expert, Assassin's Creed's senior community developer, Ubisoft's own Alice Terrett. Welcome to the show, Alice. Can you believe it's been 15 years?
Thank you so much, Danny. I cannot believe it's been 15 years.
It's a series very close to my heart because I'm in it. I'm lucky enough to voice Sean Hastings, who first appeared back in Assassin's Creed 2. Now, Sean sounds exactly like me, which may give you a clue as to the limits of my acting range. This year, we are celebrating 15 years since the release of the first Assassin's Creed.
It's been an amazing journey with our community that started back on the rooftops of the Holy Land. It has taken us to the Italian Renaissance, into the center of revolutionary wars, to ancient worlds, and to many incredible places in between. We've met unforgettable characters and been to breathtaking locations, allowing you to leap into history and relive pivotal moments from our past. It's been a phenomenal 15 years, and we are so glad that you came along for the ride. For the 15-year anniversary of Assassin's Creed, we want to truly celebrate with you, our community. We know that you've been dying to find out what's next for Assassin's Creed, and so...
Just on that point, it does sound a lot like you're about to announce a new game or something. And
I am about to announce a new game.
I just thought it'd be nice, seeing as I'm here.
So anyways, it's time to discover what we've been crafting in the shadows.
I hope you brought a trailer at least.
I have. Roll
the trailer. It's supposed to be a DLC for Valhalla, by the way. That's how it started. But let's get a good look.
Basem, Abneas Hawk, are you ready to give up who you once thought you were?
I am.
It's your boy, Basem. It's the Basem origin story.
Ready to sacrifice everything you held close?
I am.
Ready to leave your life behind and walk the path of shadows?
I am.
God damn, I can't believe I actually feel excitement for this.
Of the dark, you will come into the light. And from the light, you will return to the dark. Never forget the tenets you have sworn to uphold. Stay your blade from the flesh of the innocent. Hide in plain sight.
All right, social stealth, that's good.
Never compromise the Brotherhood.
Okay, we got a red smoke bomb for some reason, but that's still something. Okay, parkour is back. And the eagle is back, which, yeah, of course, sure, why not?
From this day forward, you are a hidden one.
All right, Assassin's Creed Mirage. And as you could see from the opening screen, that brief moment, it looked like very much like Odyssey. Oh no. Oh, this is,
Will you look at that? Assassin's Creed Mirage, everybody. And here to tell us more, it is Ubisoft Bordeaux's narrative director, Sarah Beaulieu.
All right, let's see some actual
Thank
info.
You for having me.
Sarah, we just had a little glimpse of Mirage. What can you tell us about this latest and very special Assassin's Creed adventure?
It's very special because it used to be a DLC, and then they released it as a full game.
As you know, and wanted to go back to the action-adventure game that you know, narrative-driven game. We've been focusing on stealth, parkour, and of course, assassinations.
Now, I've been playing a lot of Valhalla recently, and from watching that trailer, I couldn't help but notice Basim.
Yes, you're right. It's Basim. It's the Midnight Witch channel. It's a young Basim. He's going to be coming from a street thief to a master assassin.
Oh, fantastic. And so where does his kind of adventure begin?
Well, it begins in Baghdad. It's the beautiful, magnificent, vibrant city of Baghdad that you're going to roam through
the game. That's pretty good, man.
And it's a very dense city where you're going to meet a lot of different people.
That's amazing. I know our community is going to be very excited to explore Baghdad.
But it's not a dating sim. Tell me about the gameplay. I'm meeting people in Baghdad.
But to me, obviously, it's all about the story. So as you saw, we have a couple of charismatic characters. Starting from Basim. So Basim is our lead character. We do have Russian that you spotted in the trailer. She's Basim's mentor. We also have a lot of historical characters, like in every Assassin's Creed, some political leaders, for example, but not just. We do have a couple of very, very interesting characters in there.
Well, what a setting and what history to get your teeth into, but we're obviously about exclusives here. Have you got any more?
Yes, I do.
Good.
Did you recognize the voice from the trailer?
I did, actually. Yep. Can I reveal it? Can I reveal it?
Yeah, you know.
It was the Emmy-winning actress, wasn't it? Shore Agdashloo.
It was. Yeah,
she's pretty popular,
right.
Though.
Good.
She has an extremely distinct voice.
In the cast. Yep. She's going to be portraying Russian.
She was in The Expanse.
She's going to be the voice of Basim's mentor that you saw in the trailer, actually. And the whole team is very, very glad to have her on.
She is fantastic. Yeah, such a recognisable voice, which is why I recognised it, of course.
Well, and we were lucky enough to catch up with Shore earlier, and she had this very special message.
Okay.
Hello, everyone. I am Shore Agdashloo, and I'm thrilled to announce that I will be voicing Roshan.
she sounds like a male, like a female Joey Diaz.
When Ubisoft approached me to voice this character, I was immediately seduced by Roshan's strong personality and her backstory.
She's been eating cigarettes for the last 20 years.
She fights for justice and protects her fellow hidden ones at all costs.
Oh, she was in Tenet too. Yeah, that's true. She was in Tenet.
But keep her former self behind a shroud of mystery. And of course, the fact that she is a mature woman from Persian origins.
Oh yeah, love me some mature women,
dude. My own story and background. Playing such a character is a unique opportunity that I could not miss. I hope you will love her as much as I do. It's a real pleasure for me to collaborate with the Assassin's Creed brand and play one of the main characters in such an anticipated new game.
Okay, this is not like an amazing selling point. It's honestly not a selling point for me at all. I'm not really getting horned up by voice actors. Maybe by her though. She is a classy lady. God damn.
What a nice message. What a recognizable voice as well. Just instantly, and she seems thrilled to be part of this.
Yeah, I think she is really.
That's good. A welcome addition to the Assassin's Creed world. So finally, obviously, the question everyone wants to know. When can we get our hands on Mirage?
October.
Assassin's Creed Mirage is going to be available in 2023.
What?
And if you pre-order now, you also get the exclusive 40 Thieves side quest. But it's not all.
Oh, wait,
we also
I forgot
have a
it's September
case
now, man.
For
I'm tweaking.
As well. It includes a figurine of
I was like, yeah, next month, dude.
Surprises that you will love. Thank you, Sarah, for being with us today.
That's it.
Thank you for having me.
That's
Thank
it?
You very much. Yes, it looks fantastic.
And right. No gameplay
we'll
reveal. You're not going to say
what? News from
what?
The world of Assassin's Creed very shortly. But first, we wanted to celebrate the last 15 years of Assassin's Creed with you. Let's remind ourselves of some
another,
of the highlights and, of course,
montage.
The impact of
fantastic.
This groundbreaking series.
Another montage.
Out of the dark, you come into the light. From the light, you will return to the dark. Are you prepared to travel the Eagle's path?
Welcome aboard. It's prizes, plunder, and adventure ahead.
We are all different, but our creed will unify us.
Oh, man. All right, I get it. Look, you're gonna take the iconic theme and make it a drum and bass, like weird, like dubstep edit, and put in a bunch of footage that makes absolutely no sense from like conventions and stuff. I get it. All right, celebration, but that's all you're gonna give us is just a cinematic trailer, and not even tell us like some outline about the game, because there've been leaks that that told us more than this. There are leaks that told us that what was gonna be gone. They were gonna take away some elements of the game. The Eagle Vision is back. Parkour is gonna be back in a bigger capacity than it was. Like we saw, Social Stealth, that is back in a much bigger capacity than Valhalla, which was basically non-existent. And the lady was talking about, oh yeah, as always, we're gonna lean on the story. Yeah, the story hasn't been good for a long, long time. Story of Origins was kind of okay, but the Valhalla story was not good because it was too fractured and the main plot was just straight up bad. Story hasn't been good since, like, what? Like, Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, maybe? Which is, like, the third game in the franchise. But anyways, just play the iconic song, man. Let's play that song that's been around for 15 years. Well, this game they were talking about, it started out as a DLC for Valhalla, so it's going to be the same engine, same physics, same everything, basically.
So many memories there. Makes me want to jump back in and just play through the whole series again.
Well, Danny, to continue the celebrations, we also have a new documentary out today, honestly, which gives a behind-the-scenes look at the last 15 years of Assassin's Creed.
Something useful, please. Something useful. Not celebration stuff in YouTube videos and documentaries. Something useful, like a video game, maybe. This is a video game event, right?
Where I learned my job, where I grew.
But no, more accents instead. More accents.
So that was really the game that showed to me, hey, you gotta step it up, but like, you gotta move on from the PS2, and I fell in love ever since.
Pour moi, dans l'univers du jeu vidéo, Assassin's Creed reste une licence extrêmement importante.
Assassin's Creed, especially in those early days, was showing people what could be done in this kind of broad, open space.
Just like climbing up things and just looking at this world and being like, oh wow, I've never done this in a video game before.
You're always looking for the next Assassin's Creed, no matter which one is your favorite. You'll always be tied to it because of just how connected they've kept you in from the beginning.
Who are these people?
It has,
who reacts to this to Assassin's Creed like the most normie gamers? Come on, man. I've played every single one of those goddamn games. I would never react like this. I would react like this if I was like 12 back in like 2011. And I played Assassin's Creed 2 for the first time, and I was like, dude, what the fuck? But then it's been the same thing over and over and over and over again.
Well,
and over and over again.
To me. Where
with
can
a different
we see it?
Skin, with a different story that Loki
yes,
is all the same.
You can catch it on the Ubisoft and GTV YouTube channels, but don't go anywhere just yet.
No. So, back to business, and I've just finished the Dawn of Ragnarok expansion for Assassin's Creed Valhalla.
Fantasy, sci-fi, nonsense.
Yep, that's one of our most ambitious expansions to date. But Danny, if you want more, I've got great news.
Terrible. And they sold it separately, too. They sold it as a full thing. Because greed is massively strong.
I'm Gareth Glover, Game Director on Assassin's Creed Valhalla's post-launch. Since launch, we've continued to create new and exciting content for our community to enjoy. We've already released new game modes and activities into the world of Valhalla, such as River Raids, Tombs of the Fallen, Mastery Challenges, and more recently, the Rogue Light Forgotten Saga.
Terrible.
Today, I'm excited to announce
Rogue
that in a few months' time, we will also be launching the
also a term for repetitive.
Chapter. So let's take an exclusive first look.
Repetitive trash. That's what they mean to say. I like how I'm getting more and more hostile as this event is going on, because I'm getting let down massively.
Close.
Massively let down. What are we getting now? Something generic again?
An uproar of memories stretching far into the past. I have done all I can for my people. It is time to say goodbye. Set forth for distant shores and new adventures.
What?
Fascinated. Eivor grapples with Odin's memories in a way unfamiliar to me.
Oh, no. Is it another sci-fi thing?
I wonder.
Supposed to be the village gets destroyed. The village you've been is a free building for 70
which nicely ties up some of the storylines established throughout the game. We'll see Eivor reunite with some key characters, including some influential.
Oh, because the ending to the actual game was terrible, and then they were like, "Dude, we can't just end it like this, because this is awful."
We can't wait for you to experience it.
I can
Back
wait.
To you, Danny and Alice.
I put in like 140 hours in that game, and I'm
Danny.
Low-key regret
it. Are you ready for some more exclusives?
No, I'm not. No, I'm a little overwhelmed already. But please go on.
Okay. Well, our next guest can do just that. He's no stranger to the Assassin's Creed family, with a list of credits including creative director of Assassin's Creed Syndicate and producer of Assassin's
Creed
Odyssey.
Oh, a terrible game. I'm gonna hate this guy.
Mac. Thanks for joining us.
Well, thank you, Alice. It's great
to be here. The two worst Assassin's Creed games of all time.
Thank you. So let's start with our community. Can you tell us what makes Assassin's Creed so beloved by our global community?
Well, at Ubisoft, our mission as a company, as expressed by Eve, is to enrich the lives of players. On Assassin's Creed, we have a very clear take on that mission. We want history to be everybody's playground as we immerse players into the richness of our shared past.
Bro, what the fuck is this? Is this dude trying to talk to people who've never played Assassin's Creed before?
You see, different,
what is
though,
this?
Is this kind of unique
history. It's never been fucking historically accurate since the first game. It's always been full of nonsense and cameos by celebrities.
Mix between
Come
historical
on.
Accuracy and contemporary codes like the Animus. And when you put
playing a fucking Viking game where you can't murder civilians, the most peaceful and tolerant Vikings, get out of here with your historical nonsense. Can't even kill people in a raid. You raid a monastery, you can't even kill the priests. You're not allowed.
That together, it gives you the chance to embody iconic characters, to live powerful fantasies,
the iconic character,
all the while
Eivor.
Immersed in intriguing historical settings.
It's amazing. So how will Assassin's Creed evolve in the coming years?
Well, we're going to double down on our passion for history.
A live service.
As we explore the past with courage. We strongly believe that history can be the most powerful and eye-opening source of entertainment. And our teams believe that history can help us better understand the world that we live in, as so many elements from the past still resonate with our present. But don't worry, we're going to keep telling grand epic stories so that viewers and players alike can feel the vertigo that only human history can bring.
Oh, so a bunch of revisionist history and a bunch of celebrity cameos again.
You talk about history and about using history as a playground. What an incredible thing to be able to use history in this way. But what does this mean for
you? Rewrite history. That's what you're doing.
Well, we want our passion for history to fuel the expansion of the franchise into new territories. So I'm very happy to announce today our very first open world Assassin's Creed game for mobile.
Yo, what?
It will feature.
Yo, what? What? This you fucking reveal mobile again? This like the fourth mobile game in this whole event. Yo, what the fuck? I'm busting out the soundboard for this one. Man, I'm gonna go crazy on the soundboard.
That's retarded. That's retarded. That's retarded. That's retarded. That's retarded. That's retarded. That's
Wow, mobile game, get out of here.
Iconic Assassin's Creed.
Open the door, throw this man out.
Read gameplay, but optimized
mobile.
For an experience on touch controls. And I just can't
You're gonna
wait
give
to
me a bunch of shitty fucking trailers and fan videos, and then you're gonna say mobile.
Tell you more about the story.
What a joke,
And the setting.
I'm so glad I streamed this, because otherwise I would just be yelling at my laptop. And now I actually have an excuse, because this is going to go on YouTube eventually, and you guys are watching it, so thanks a lot.
Let's take a look at the trailer.
Thanks a lot. And we're getting a trailer for this.
That's retarded.
You're bagging.
This is like a Mission 1 fucking franchise. Oh yeah, ancient China, of course.
You're still on Mission 1.
Terrible. Terrible. Of course, ancient China. Are we gonna get this on like console, or is it just a mobile thing? Because you wanna push the mobile. Give me a break. That's actually disgusting. I'm actually like repulsed by this. And of course they're making it in China because they're putting it on fucking mobile. Of course. This is just like shambles. A franchise in shambles. Of course. Put it in China, put it on the phone, ship it. Put the Assassin's Creed sticker on it. We're in the game, we're playing. And that was it. There was no like actual gameplay or anything. Look. Just a shitty cinematic trailer.
That a brand new Assassin's Creed game set.
Dude is not even gonna pretend to be like hyped.
In China, it looks amazing. Matt, can you tell us China, a little bit more about the features?
Well, for the first time in our open world games, you can create your own character. You'll get the chance to do things like parkour atop the...
Of course you can create your own character, because then you can create your own microtransactions. Of course. Because it's going to be your character, man. It's just literally Assassin's Creed Immortal. You're right. Assassin's Creed Immortal.
Great Wall of China. Sneak through bustling cities, engage in intense combat, and discover the secrets of vastness of ancient China.
Well, that leads me to my next question. So, Mac, many of us know that a Netflix show is in development. Oh, and Netflix, would like to know
of
more.
Course.
What else can you tell
us? This is just a big fucking circle jerk for other properties that's not Assassin's Creed.
Well, it's still...
In a half-assed game that they have premiered. Early they didn't say anything about. They said the voice actress is gonna sound cool. Well, big ups for that.
Development, but I can confirm that we are co-developing the Netflix series with Ubisoft Film and Television, Netflix, obviously, and an insanely talented showrunner, Jeb Stuart. It's going to be an epic, genre-bending, a live-action adaptation of our video game series.
Is it like the movie?
But that's not the only thing we have in development
with Netflix.
With Michael
Fassbender, that amazing
movie? We also have a new mobile game in development for their platform.
Jesus fucking Christ, another mobile game! Another mobile game for fucking Netflix! Another mobile game! Another one! Jesus Christ, another!
Huh? How does that make any sense?
For fucking Netflix of all things! It's not even on the Stadia! It's on Netflix!
Wow, so you're doing quite a lot with Netflix. And just out of interest, there's no reason for me to ask this. This is just curious. A lot
no
of people
way.
Probably want to know. Who is the casting director for that?
Why do you want to know?
No, just that a lot of people have been tweeting in about that.
Well, we'll put this
name celebrity.
On screen. I'll talk to you after about that. In the meantime, let's take a look at the wider world of Assassin's Creed.
Let's see what this is. Another mobile game. Okay, live concert, symphonic adventure. You guys are... Is this fucking banter? Is this a fucking out-of-season April Fool's joke, like the dude said in the thing? A figurine? They're completely selling everything, man. They're the biggest sellout franchise of all time. Holy shit. Please never buy this. And a book, of course. And a webtoon sequel to Black Flag?
Well, the wider world of Assassin's Creed there. And look, we've had a lot of surprises
here.
Today. I think that's fair to say. But in the grand tradition of surprises, Mac, I think you might have saved the biggest one for last.
Well, Danny, that's right. Believe it or not, I've got more things to show to
what,
you.
Assassin's Creed
how
Infinity?
About we take a leap of faith into the future together?
Let's take a look.
Oh, yeah, it's Assassin's Creed Infinity. Let's see where the first one's going to be. It's going to be in Japan because Ghosts of Tsushima stole their lunch money and showed them how to do an Assassin's Creed game. gonna be Assassin's Creed Morbius? There you go, Japan. There you go. Is this gonna be on mobile too? Tell me it's a mobile game.
I think that's what you call big news, isn't it? I mean, there's a lot of stuff in there that I think, from your point of view, certainly the community, the fans have been asking for a long time. So, Mac, tell us more.
Well, this is codename Red, our next premium flagship title and the future of our open-world RPG games on Assassin's Creed.
And the worst thing is this dude is announcing it. This dude that was creative director for Syndicate. A game that took all the good things from Unity and took them away and put in a zipline instead. That's what this sick motherfucker did.
Developed by Ubisoft Quebec, the studio behind Assassin's Creed Odyssey,
and big ups, under the creative Dragon direction big ups of Jonathan Sulu.
It Thanks will let players explore
I've
one
been
of
losing
their
my
most
shit over this Assassin's Creed premiere. I didn't expect it to be that bad. Honestly, I am actually losing my shit. This is one of my favorite franchises, and I've gone so bitter over it over the ages based on how much they fucked it up.
Ever on the franchise, feudal Japan, and they'll live a very powerful shinobi fantasy.
I mean, people have been waiting for this for a long time.
Yeah, what happened to it? They would rather make literally everything else. They made ancient fucking Greek assassins, where you fight the Minotaur and a Medusa before they made this. And it took Sucker Punch making one of the games that is superior to Assassin's Creed in every single way for them to wake the fuck up and make an Assassin's Creed in Japan. And now it's probably too late.
Haven't they?
Yes, they have.
Well, they certainly have, and now you brought it to them.
It's amazing.
Which is good, and you're slightly cruel in that you're teasing me with it. I very much want that. You mentioned some of the other studios. What's Montreal up to right now?
Well, we have our veteran team behind Assassin's Creed Valhalla in Montreal, the birthplace of Assassin's Creed, who's been hard at work on a new flagship title as well. It is being led by creative director Clint Hawking.
Okay.
It is a very different type of Assassin's Creed game.
And
also, they're going to make a bunch of Assassin's Creed games that are all different. Holy shit, man. These dudes are just... They're going all out.
Eve, you may have brought us something that we can watch now. Yes, here it is.
Hey, let's see. What is this going to be? This is another one of the Infinity Saga games. Another flagship title that is completely different. Where is it based? Is it in India? Is it in Spain? Is it in Portugal? Is it in Romania? Come on, everybody. Assassin's Creed? I don't know. Salem Witch Trials? I don't know. What is this? Codename Hex. So nothing, basically. About witches, of course. Yeah, it looks like it's about witches.
Well, the surprises just keep on coming. What can you tell
is
us about
Russia?
This project?
Well, this is codename Hexe, and I can't wait for our fans to tear apart that trailer and find out all its secrets.
Bro, this
yeah,
is so
absolutely.
Fucking stupid,
and
I
work
swear.
Out the code name. You guys have always got code names for stuff. There was it a year ago? There was codename Infinity. Where
oh,
are
yeah.
you with that?
Well, that's a great question, Danny, and I'm happy to give you a little bit more about Project Infinity today. Infinity is not a game per se. Is going to be the single entry point for our fans into the Assassin's
oh,
Creed
no,
franchise.
No, no. They told you a long time ago. Hey, big ups Cameron McGinty 00. Big ups, man. Big ups for the follow. No, they called it like a year ago. Assassin's Creed Infinity. It's going to be like a modular Assassin's Creed. Where it's gonna be Project This and Project That and Project Purple, Project 69, Project fucking everything. And it's gonna be a bunch of live service circle jerks.
Into the
terrible,
future.
Terrible, man.
So you're
terrible.
Saying that players will be able to explore their very own animus, kind of like a time machine?
Yes.
Exactly, Alice.
Yes.
Infinity
they
is going
it.
To be a hub that will unite all our different experiences and our
So it's going to be all of those games are going to have the same engine. They're going to look the same, feel the same, play very similarly. Terrible.
Pairs together in meaningful ways.
Terrible. And all they're going to be filled with garbage.
So, obviously, that begs the question, if you're connecting players and there's more than one player.
It's going to be multiplayer. Yeah, that's what you're asking.
You'll be thinking, are we talking multiplayer?
Yes, we are.
Well, Danny, it seems we can't hide anything from you.
You can't.
So we're actually investigating how we will bring back standalone multiplayer experiences into the Assassin's Creed universe, all connected to the Infinity Hub.
This is literally the worst. This is literally the worst. And I hope it falls down in flame, man. This is the worst.
It sounds extraordinary. You must have a nap at some point because you've all been very, very busy.
Of course,
so,
they have a roadmap.
Mac, some major new developments there, and I'm sure everyone at home can't wait to get involved. Thank you for joining us today,
man,
and sharing all this incredibly exciting news.
Literally every single terrible practice was on display in this two-hour show. Was it a two-hour show? What does it say? Four-hour show. This can be true. Anyways. Yeah, it was a two-hour show, man. Every single terrible practice. Mobile games. What was it? Like, CGI trailers with no gameplay. Half-assed misleading trailers. Trailers with barely any gameplay for games that have been in development for the last, like, 6 years. So bad. And in the end, we wrap it up with live service and mobile games. This is the worst.
Well, thank you, Danny. Thank you, Alice. It's been a pleasure.
The worst. Let's keep in and see what
then
we got.
Then in 2023, okay, we'll see the release of the next big title, Assassin's Creed Mirage.
The next big title, by the way, made on the same engine as Valhalla. Initially planned to be DLC. So you already know how this is going to feel. You already know how it's going to play.
Set in Baghdad and following the story of Basim.
In Baghdad, it's going to be a downscaled game. It's going to be smaller and more streamlined from what the leaks say. Which the leaks were correct about everything up to this point, so yeah.
From Street Thief to Master Assassin.
And then we got in 2024, we got Codename Red, which is the Japanese Assassin's Creed, and Codename Hex, which is, who cares, something else Assassin's Creed. That's going to be the start of Assassin's Creed Infinity. Jesus Christ, I cannot believe my eyes.
Up slipping into my Ezio cosplay as normal.
Serious?
Okay, are we gonna go back to like Andrew Tate?
We hope you enjoyed it.
There we go. There we go.
Liam, that was one hell of a show.
And the dude that hyped.
Say that again.
I think he his energy dropped a little bit at the Assassin's Creed presentation because it was terrible.
That was one hell of a show.
Well, that does it for this edition of Ubisoft Forward. We hope you enjoyed it.
Bro. I'm fucking done, man. This was Forward. Let's go in, let's go through it, do a quick recap, right? We start off with Andrew Tate and Lady, right? They give us a preview of the stuff that we love and is already existing, right? Including a bunch of like indie games and stuff that people are developing. Then we get The Crew 2 and a DeLorean. Then we get this dude who was super confusing. He was working for Ubisoft, but he used to do cosplay. But then again, he doesn't do anything related to design. He does some marketing shit. Anyways, then we go to a promo of Anno 1800 and the next patch. Then we go to a promo of Trackmania and a bunch of cool gaming clips by gamers. Then we go Mario Rabbids. This is the first thing they present. Then we go Skull and Bones, right? Was it Skull and Bones? Oh, yeah. This was a bunch of dudes that played the game that tell you how excited they are for you to play the game. And then this lady that is super excited to play the game was just showing to you some very, very basic gameplay that was, like, suspiciously basic. And then a bunch of cutscenes, and that was kind of it. And then we go The Division shilling with a bunch of new stuff. The Division mobile game. A Division, what was it? A Battle Royale type of thing. Then we get Rainbow Six Mobile. Absolutely wonderful. Then we get Just Dance, Trackmania, what was the name? Rocksmith. Then we jump into Assassin's Creed with a bunch of celebratory celebration segments. Then we got Eve showing up and giving us a big ups for buying all his stupid games. And then we get the sit down where we present a new Assassin's Creed. We only show a cinematic trailer. We show an actual voice actress. We flex having a voice actress for this one. And then we present absolutely the worst most terrible business practices with mobile games and live service games, an exclusive Assassin's Creed Mobile taking place in China, Assassin's Creed Japan that is long overdue, that is a part of a new live service, Assassin's Creed Infinity. And man, I ran out of nerves, I ran out of voice, I ran out of, I don't know, brain cells. And then they got this dude, who is a creative director for Assassin's Creed Syndicate, one of the worst ones, the one that basically was kind of the end of the old Assassin's Creeds, and then it was so bad that it forced the whole game into like a midlife crisis, the whole franchise. And he was also creative director for Odyssey, or some guy for Odyssey. He worked on Odyssey, one of the worst Assassin's Creeds and one of my most hated games. Oh, that's a good one, Jim Bean, as well. They collaborated with Netflix on a bunch of games, mobile games, that are going to be on Netflix mobile game service. So this was by far one of the worst events that I've literally watched of all time. One of the worst gaming events. I've never seen a more out of touch, stupid, and honestly just a terrible event. Okay, now we can focus on the positive stuff. Big ups Adonis 11 for the follow, and big ups to Fine Lines, man. What's up, you in chat, and what's up Adonis 11 in chat. Now we are done with this, so now I guess we could do some other stuff. Let's see what's up on YouTube. Let's see what's up our guy Darks Fadil. How is he doing? Oh no, he's sitting at 15 buckaroos, man, and the members have grown by 2. Slow and steady wins the race, as they say. What else can we do on this Twitch stream, man? Maybe play some games. Maybe I can go to bed. I don't know. Let's see what Twitter thinks about this, if I'm even logged on Twitter. Let's see what Twitter thinks about Assassin's Creed. And maybe we could do some, what's it called? Oh, Royal Family, rip. Big ups Gara 319 for the follow, man. Big ups. We could do some song requests. Let's do Assassin's Creed. Let's see what they say. Oh wow, Codename Red. Open our future open world RPG. Already sounds terrible. The RPG is losing me, man. These games should not be RPGs. You are not good at making RPGs. Because Ubisoft, when they hear RPG, they hear make the health bar big. And make the upgrades mean that you deal 5% more damage. Absolutely terrible. Terrible, terrible, terrible. Codename Jade started development over 3 years ago. So the Chinese Assassin's Creed started development 3 years ago, according to Daniel Ahmad. And he's basically never wrong, from what I know. So yeah, absolutely terrible, man. Terrible. And the only thing you can kind of look forward to is this one, is Mirage, and this is basically kind of the same game as Valhalla, except of course it's in a new place. Let's see, what was about Tencent? Oh, it is. That's a good spot. It's part of the Tencent Ubisoft partnership to bring more UBIPs to mobile. Absolutely depressing. I cannot believe this. Hey, it's a new local post. Let's see what this is.
Make about you. Hey, jackass. These stupid little videos that I like to make about you. One take. No effort.
One take, hey, no effort. Dude, this is how Ubisoft does their stuff. One take, no effort. You don't have to care. Yo, it's a Mandalorian Season 2 trailer drop. Let's see what's on the YouTube Explorer. Let's go through it together. Yo, what? The Little Mermaid, but with oh my god, this is getting eviscerated. Look at this ratio. Yo, let's dive in. It can't be just because she's black. It must look actually terrible. Please don't be just because she's black. That's very mean. Even though she should definitely be a white redhead. That's just what the Little Mermaid is. Alright. You know, do you see how they intentionally are hiding her face? It's intentional, man. They're doing it on purpose. They want people to be pissed. Because in today's day and age, they're trying to do... when something doesn't stand by itself on its own merits and it's kind of trash, they just makes a controversial, like a political decision, basically, like race baiting. They're trying to get you pissed off because they made somebody black, so you can talk about it. You see, they're baiting you, man. They're not showing the face on purpose. What can be that special about the face they're not showing you? I'm very interested. Because you know this movie's gonna be a piece of shit. And it's not gonna be because she's black, it's gonna be because it's gonna be terribly written and probably very badly acted. And the songs are gonna be ass. You see, oh, they showed the thing, man. Oops, and now they show her face. And you're like, what? This is the Little Mermaid? Huh? And of course, and that's why we got the half a mil downvotes on a minute... on a minute 30 long trailer that shows nothing. This shows nothing. It shows nothing. And of course, now you're gonna see all the articles. Racists come out and despise this movie just because she's black. Let's see what else we got. Hocus Pocus 2. Shout out Hocus Pocus 2. Then we got a new Tom McDonald song. Then we got the Queen and the King and NBA 2K. Big ups NBA 2K. It's probably exactly the same like the last one. That's why I'm not buying it. And also because, I don't know. Oh, Black Adam with a new trailer. Probably going to watch that movie eventually. Because it's Rocky in it. Is the Rock Man. Chess cheating drama update. Oh, that was there was a big thing about chess. I don't play chess, but there was like a bunch of drama about it. Pretty weird. And I guess that's it, man. That's with the explore page, basically. It's with the explore page. What else we got? Do we got any music we can check out? Maybe on Twitch they allow you to listen to music like a human being, and they don't terminate you immediately. So maybe I can do like a song review. How about a song review, guys? I don't know, because I don't really feel like playing games, because I'm probably going to wrap it up soon. Let's see this. Camilo. Aeropuerto. Official video. But this is... I can already hear how this sounds. And ESTG. Shoot It Myself. Feed Future. Let's give it a shot. All right. Yeah. Yeah.
Shirt off with no mask at all. I train my dog with Manitow. Clear as water. Yeah. This the one. Yeah. Made Jesus take his sandals off. Yeah. Come knock on the devil's door. Yeah. Make sure you turn your camera off. It's Jay's in here. White all on they face, but they ain't Santa Claus.
Yeah. Wait, what is James Harden in this?
Take to get this car. Never thought I'd get this far. Both my arms, my wrists are sore. I never
Why is he not playing basketball, dude?
Sam 6-2 clip curve and it's AI for protection. Karma can't even catch up. Then my first dirt like 07. Even back then I tell you I'ma be like this forever.
All right, I made a swell to I guess it's like the song. Give me the future. Yeah. Yeah, now we're talking.
1,001 trillion bullets come behind my name.
All right, that's gonna be it. Okay, I'm gonna wrap it up and go to bed. Wait, what is this? Disenchanted official trailer, Disney Plus. I would never watch this. I don't care about this. This can get lost. And yeah, we got a DSP video from some dude. Turns into Alpha 5 Saints Row Salt. And I guess that's it, man. Shout out everybody that stopped by. This video is going to go on YouTube, so if you don't like Twitch, you're probably going to see it there. Make sure to check out the second channel on YouTube for the VOD. And that's going to be it, man. Thanks for watching the Assassin's Creed thing with me, even if you don't care about Assassin's Creed, because other stuff wasn't great for certain. It wasn't great at all, man. So thanks. Big ups everybody who followed. Shout out to you. And yeah, come back next time for whatever I do. It's probably gonna be some gaming stuff, some random stuff. So yeah. See you around. Thanks for the stream and for the positivity and the positive start to this Twitch journey. So yeah, if I'm not banned for making fun of the Little Mermaid, next time I'm gonna be back and we're gonna have fun again. All right, see you around.